you are looking at a woman 4 or 5 years ago. I never would have been able to do this. In fact, had anyone told me in 4 or 5 years ago, I would sit here at TED Talk speaking to you guys, and then I would have believed it. Success is an attitude, but what are the challenges? We are constantly reminded that the road to success isn't easy. Everyone tells us that. We even tell ourselves that. From our parents, to our teachers, to people or celebrities who their lives we aspire to be, they all remind us of that. But I believe success is just a benchmark that we have subconsciously set upon ourselves. Aspirations, really, dreams and wishes we have about our future. As uncertain as the road to success may be, having the right attitude and the willingness to live on the edge of your fears by taking the risk to turn the intangible into something tangible is what will set you apart from your peers. My name is Lisette Mibo. I am a model turned philanthropist and the founder of Passion for Motherland. I spent the first 14 years of my life in the Democratic Republic of Congo before joining the rest of my family in the United Kingdom in 2002. Whilst in the Congo, I moved from houses to houses without the protection of a safe and stable home. I was put in vulnerable situations, not fit for a child, both physically and emotionally. Until one day I couldn't handle it anymore and decided to run away in the evening and went to find where my grandmother was living. I was 11 years old only. I took off in the middle of the night, a 2 hours car journey by foot, then jumping from one bus to another. Thankfully for me, I had somewhere to go. Compared to many Congolese youth your age finding themselves in the street because they have nowhere else to go. There are thousands of them. Their only option is to be on the street where they are subjected to even more danger, abuse, possibly death. In December 2015, I traveled back to the Congo to pay my last respect to a woman who was dear to me, who played a key role in my life, my grandmother, who passed away. Whilst in the Congo, I realized how dreadful the situation of street children was. And I suddenly felt a responsibility, because 14, 15 years ago, that could have been one of them, if not for my grandmother. So I am determined to be part of the solution, and I believe it's doable. You know, according to UNICEF, there are between 22 to 25,000 children abandoned by their families in Kinshasa for one reason or the other, but primarily due to witchcraft allegations and economic reasons, such as poverty. One of the organizations I visited when I was in Kinshasa and who is taking care of some of these kids is called Au Pair, which is short for œuvre de reclassement et de protection des enfants de la rue in French, which is translated in English as the work of reclassification and the protection of street children. Even an organization such as Au Pair can do so much. What I'm about to share with you is nothing out of the ordinary. Just a story about a life still to be lived. I believe every one of you here can relate to me one way or the other. There are different types of elements in life, such as obstacles, which can be a lack of job experience, a language barrier, that can stand in our way, that can discourage us from pursuing our dreams, our goals, because of fear of failure. I've had to overcome many of these elements in my life. Firstly, as a neglected child, in the hands of people whom my mother trusted to look after me in her absence while she prepared for me to join her here in the UK. Secondly, as an immigrant in a foreign country, having to adapt to a new culture and learn a new language. I came to England in secondary school. to be precise, in year 10. And as you can imagine, full of teenage awkwardness. And I only had 1 year to start for my GCSEs with no English whatsoever. Can you imagine? Well, thank God, I managed to finish. And I received a good grade in some special subjects, such as French. I got an A star, by the way. Fast forward to university. It was an exciting period for me, you know, being a first year student, having all these aspirations and hopes. But also, I was anxious about the future. As so of you are, even some of you are in college, I'm sure you're wondering what you want to do, where I want to be, I want to be a housewife, no, I want to be a medicine, I want to get into medicine, I want to be a lawyer, I want to change the world, you know, you're anxious. But I was also very excited about one thing, my first big paycheck of student loan. Not knowing the amount of debt which was waiting for me once I graduate. And by the way, I'm still paying for it. The beauty of living on the edge is that it keeps us on our toes. Challenges are part of life, and it's needed in order to give us a big push. My biggest challenge came during my second year of university. I became a mother, and I gave birth to my beautiful daughter Priska in 2010, and graduated the following year. Looking back at it now, I made a conscious decision to not quit university, though I knew it would be difficult balancing motherhood and university. And I also had great support from my fiancé at the time, yes, my family and my friends, even my university, which was very invaluable for me. But I also believed in myself. I believed in my potentials, my capabilities, and I put myself up for the challenge. Okay, side note here. I'm not here trying to advise you to get pregnant while you're studying. And I'm not responsible if you do. But on a serious note, if something like that happened, the unexpected, just don't forget, keep your mind towards your dreams. There are a lot of support out there. You have families and friends. Our education system is there to support us. You're not alone, and don't forget your dreams. My daughter brought a lot of focus in my life. Motherhood meant having to work 10 times harder, including pursuing a demanding modeling career. And to my accolade, I have since graced many magazines covers, and I've won awards. I have come a long way, but what is my story? That of a little girl running in the streets of Kinshasa, homeless, coming to England to join her family, not being able to speak English, to finding my passion through motherhood, and from graduating with a degree in criminology with sociology. I have created a platform for myself, and I have found a voice for myself and for all the little boys and girls in my country of origin, the Congo. The birth of Passion for Motherland is deeply rooted in this tale. It was founded in 2013 as a platform with an objective to raise funds and awareness to support existing organizations running empowering projects at a grassroots level in the Democratic Republic of Congo. This year though, Patrick Magland will launch its first project for the benefit of street children in Kinshasa. The mission is for empowerment through education, skills acquisition, macroeconomic loans, medical assistance, to name a few. Something that I'm very proud of. And it feels personal to me, knowing that without my grandmother, I too would have been one of them. And it also allows me to leave a legacy for her. Another challenge, which I'm ready to put myself through. As you have learned now, my life has been all about challenges, and this one is not different. You see, I love a bit of challenging life, you know? Once you have that essay, you have that deadline, those sleepless nights, And then you have those grades. You're just like, yes, because I worked for it. That's the whole point. Challenges shouldn't scare us away. It should motivate us, push harder. And I am looking forward to this another challenge which stays ahead of me in the Congo. And Britain too. But there's a lot of need here too. And Britain is a home to me too. You know? So I say this unto you, that challenges are part of life. They come in different forms, often unexpected. But they mold and prepare us for the real world. I hope to have inspired you today. That you too, you can overcome those challenges. You can break barriers and come out to the other side stronger, happier, and better. While navigating through your college website, I find it very interesting that one of your core missions is to bring together a dynamic community of young people from truly diverse backgrounds to facilitate intercultural engagement and motivate students to create a more peaceful world. It is my hope that upon finishing your studies, you will go out into the world and become a transformative force, an element of positive change. Thank you for listening to me.